Hi, it's Dr. Z. I will be reviewing how to report results for hypothesis tests. Specifically, I will explain how to write summary and interpretation statements for one-tailed and two-tailed hypothesis tests using Z-scores. Our first lecture example this week asks the question, do blueberry supplements have an effect on cognitive function? To test this question, a nurse practitioner asked one patient, or a sample of one person, to take the blueberry supplement for 6 months. After 6 months, the patient scored X equals 92 on the Wunderlich cognitive ability test, which measures cognitive functioning. Since this was considered new research, we were not sure what effect or what direction blueberry supplements would have on cognitive functioning. Thus, we used a two-tailed hypothesis test. We used a 0.05 significance level, two-tailed, when conducting the hypothesis test, and we calculated a Z of +3 for the sample. And we made the decision to reject the null hypothesis. In other words, rejecting the null hypothesis means that something probably happened. More specifically, it appears that blueberry supplements have an effect on cognitive functioning. Now, let's discuss how to report the results of this two-tailed hypothesis test. First, the summary statement explains what happened in the study. The first sentence will briefly describe the study and report the sample score or the sample mean. Thus, for this lecture example, the first sentence would be, patient who had taken blueberry supplements had X equals 92 on cognitive functioning. The second sentence will report the calculated Z-score, the significance level you used, and statistical significance. Thus, for this lecture example, the second sentence would be, blueberry supplements had a statistically significant effect on cognitive functioning, comma, Z equals +3, comma, P is less than 0.5. I do want to point out that this is a sentence and you need to end it in a period. Now, second, the interpretation statement attempts to explain the results of the study in a more simplified way. In other words, it explains the results in a way that your grandma could understand. So let's reflect on our initial thoughts when rejecting the null hypothesis. We stated that something probably happened, and more specifically, we said that it appears that blueberry supplements have an effect on cognitive functioning. Now, let's get even more specific and ask what kind of an effect was it? The Z-score was a +3, which indicated that cognitive functioning increased. Well, guess what? That is our interpretation statement. Blueberry supplements appear to increase cognitive functioning. And that is how simple an interpretation statement is when you make the decision to reject the null hypothesis. Our second lecture example this week asks the question, can blueberry supplements improve cognitive performance? To test this question, a nurse practitioner asked one patient, a sample of one person, to take the blueberry supplement for 6 months. After 6 months, the patient scored X equals 87 on the Wunderlich cognitive ability test, which measures cognitive functioning. After studying the effects of blueberry supplements for several years, it is now considered established research, as researchers know in what direction the effect will be. Thus, we used a one-tailed hypothesis test. We used a 0.05 significance level one-tailed when conducting the hypothesis test, and we calculated a Z of +1.75 for the sample, and we then made the decision to reject the null hypothesis. In other words, rejecting the null hypothesis means that something probably happened. More specifically, it appears that blueberry supplements have an increase on cognitive functioning. Now, let's report the results of this one-tailed hypothesis test. The summary statement will use the same format as before. The first sentence will be, patient who had taken blueberry supplements had X equals 87 on cognitive functioning. The second sentence would be, blueberry supplements had a statistically significant effect on cognitive functioning, comma, z equals plus 1.75, comma, p is less than 0.05, and then one tail in parentheses. Since we used a one-tailed hypothesis test, we must indicate that in that second sentence. So, what will the interpretation statement be? Let's reflect on our initial thoughts when rejecting the null hypothesis. We stated that something probably happened. More specifically, we said that it appears that blueberry supplements have an increase on cognitive functioning. Well, there you have it. Blueberry supplements appear to increase cognitive functioning. Now, please note that both lecture examples happen to result in the decision to reject the null hypothesis. If we were to fail to reject the null hypothesis instead, or have the z-score fall just outside of the critical region, the summary and interpretation statements would look different. Refer to the lecture handout for details.